we're about to get real about synthetic data. Welcome back to the AI Generation, a series where we dive into all things Gen AI. I'm Dominique Weatherspoon. Sometimes you need data and you don't have data. Sometimes you have data and you can't use it. That's when synthetic data generation comes in. Synthetic data generation is a subset of generative AI, and it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a process of generating data that mirrors the characteristics of real data. And it has some very real benefits. Synthetic data is becoming really important. Teams need more data so they can do more with AI and collaborate more freely. More data equals more innovation. And Gen AI models specifically require large amounts of data for training. If you're wondering, how on earth do we not have enough data? I could understand that. Forbes estimates that 2.5 quintillion bytes of data are created each day, but it becomes a matter of quality, not quantity. Using synthetic data helps to protect private information, keeping personal information from leaking into AI models. It provides a much more cost-effective alternative to manual data collection or buying third-party data sets. It can also address bias by ensuring sufficient representation across groups when training models. And it's much more scalable than real data. Data and AI teams can greatly benefit from this new technology because having a strong data foundation with easy and fast access to usable, high-quality data is essential to developing models. Not to mention that real data has to be labeled by hand. A highly manual, time-intensive, and error-prone process. Using synthetic data means that teams can innovate faster. To understand this a bit more, we're going to hear from data science expert Ali Ricke, who will explain why synthetic data is becoming more important to data and AI teams.
This is a fast-growing technology. Analysts predict that by 2026, 75% of businesses will use synthetic customer data, up from less than 5% in 2023. There are a ton of reasons for this. Elevated privacy risk is one. Laws and regulations are constantly being added to address data privacy, and businesses and data scientists have to keep up. And models require a lot of data for training, so data and AI teams simply need more. Here are a few real-world examples. There are use cases across industries, but the financial services industry appears to be ahead of the game in using synthetic data. It's common for data sets to be unbalanced, with some classes or categories underrepresented. This can create model bias. Consider a credit underwriting model, where you could have more males who approve for loans than females. Synthetic data can balance this out to make sure the gender bias is addressed. A bank may also have a rare but important scenario where they just don't have enough relevant data to train models. Banks need to fight fraud, but fraud cases make up a tiny percentage of transaction records. So banks can use this technology to build out a more substantial data set for fraud detection models. Also, look at the life sciences industry. Synthetic data can be a huge help in clinical trials. The data from the trial has sensitive patient information, but that same data is crucial in evaluating the new treatment. Synthetic data can mimic the properties of the real data, minus the privacy issues. In all of those cases, you can see how synthetic data can help data scientists be more efficient and accurate.
That's really eye-opening into how helpful this can be. We're now going to talk to synthetic data specialist Brett Wujek. Brett, can you tell us about an interesting use case?
Hi, Dominique. Yeah, we are seeing a ton of interest from organizations wanting to take advantage of synthetic data and the promise it holds for their AI development efforts and for their organizations overall. One of those was a large retail bank in the UK, and they wanted to enrich and enhance their models for unsecured personal loans, asking the question, could augmenting the data sets with synthetic data improve their credit risk model accuracy? And the answer was a resounding yes. Using synthetic data generation led to a 38% improvement in Gini. Now, if you don't know what the Gini coefficient is, it's a It's a metric that's commonly used in the finance industry to evaluate models and assess how well those models can distinguish between defaulting and non-defaulting borrowers. So really important. And that meant that there was a significant 38% improvement in the model's ability to weed out defaulting borrowers. This would ultimately end up saving the bank 10.3 million pounds, almost $13 million in losses from their estimates. And they thought this was really just the start for their organization. If they could apply these same synthetic data techniques for their mortgage loans, they estimate the benefit could increase by tenfold, and that's just a huge savings.
Do you have any advice for data and AI teams who want to start using this new technology?
Absolutely. It all starts with a solid understanding of the nature of the data associated with your business problem and how you want or need to use synthetic data for that. Are you trying to achieve better balance or representation among groups to reduce bias? Are you trying to account for rare events or corner cases more thoroughly? You just have to be comfortable and confident that the synthetic data you generate is a good and realistic representation of the data you need to accurately and effectively solve your business problem. And there are assessments and quality checks you can do to ensure this, and all the while still, you know, remain mindful of adhering to data privacy regulations, which of course is very important and one of the main reasons people want to use synthetic data. So you can't go into this blindly, but if you take a very deliberate and disciplined approach to using the technology, you stand to reap the benefits of enhancing and accelerating your model development efforts and boosting model performance, all of which, of course, ultimately contributes to improving the bottom line for an organization.
Thanks, Brett. So, now we know what synthetic data is and why it's becoming more important by the day. Data and AI teams using it are seeing real benefits. In one Gartner survey, 60% of respondents reported improved model accuracy, and 56% reported improved efficiency, plus big privacy and bias improvements. Numbers like those mean we're going to be hearing a lot more about this. If you want to learn more about synthetic data, we have lots of resources linked in the description. Have some questions? Drop them in the chat. And subscribe so you don't miss our other episodes. I'll see you next time on The AI Generation.